something seems to have happened to the Indian culture. We have on the one hand a whole number of people, not merely Shankara, all the great acharyas were like that. There is reflecting on experience, thinking about experience and saying that, take experience as your reference point. So we had people who gave us, taught us about the nature of experience. Suddenly something seems to have happened in the Indian tradition, that we stop producing these kind of, well, call them intellectuals or acharyas, whatever you want to call them, in the sense that those who then started discoursing, whether at the later stage in university in the last 200 years, or even I think during the Islamic colonialism, the pundits, they seem to have lost contact with this ability to reflect on experience. So that experiential knowledge becomes bookish knowledge under Islamic colonialism, and more or less disappears under British colonialism. Yeah? Now, the question is, what should we be doing today? Because there is no point in simply reviving texts and stories of 1,000 years ago. Yeah? Ordinary man doesn't understand it. Now, why ordinary man? I mean, you speak about Manovikara, you speak about Chitta Shuddhi, if you ask someone, where is your Chitta, what is Manovikara, what's the difference between the two, you won't be able to explain. Unless you go and read some, you know, text or the other, which will give you some understanding. But even then you have lots of, even though they are part of the natural language, we don't know what they mean. So we cannot go back and simply reproduce a Shankara or a Ramanuja or any of these acharyas. There is no transmission of this kind of reflection left to us. The intellectuals we have, in whose tradition we have come, that is through the universities and so on, we tell some stories about Karl Marx, Max Weber and so on, but we are simply taught that India is a backward country. There is no hope for India. The only hope is very simple, we become as quickly as possible, we become like the West. This is a story I was brought up, yeah, at school, in the university. And for a long period of time I believed it, I genuinely believed it. I was against the caste system, I was against Brahmanism, I found all these gods of foolish things and so on. I have had my part of revolution also. Until I discovered how wrong these stories all were. Yeah? In fact, quite a few of us came through that period, that formative period, where we rebelled against everything Indian. Yeah? We were ashamed to be Indians, in a very deep sense. So today you have a generation coming which is even less, which relates even less to the Indian tradition than I myself relate. At least I had a very
odd. At least you had a fight. Yeah. They don't have even that.
Yeah. Exactly. Now the question is, what should we be doing in a situation like this? I mean, what should be the responsibility of people? I'll tell you why I'm asking this. Some time ago I had a long discussion with, perhaps you know him or heard of him, Chap called Ashok Chowdhury, who is the National Vice President of the VHP. I found that one of the biggest weaknesses.
I'm little aware of institutions.
Okay. Now, this man is the head of this Vishwa Hindu Parishad. So I had a discussion with him. I was invited to a conference in Coimbatore. First time I met him. I found that one of the things that VHP, BJP lack is intellectuals. Yeah, they don't have intellectuals.
Oh.
Not only that, they disrespect intellectuals.
I have seen much of it.
You have. And I asked him why. I said, do you realize you're losing the head? And if you don't have intellectuals, if you don't have people. But he says, no, we don't want intellectuals. How do you understand that?
I told them long ago, when in the name of social relevance, all our arts are spoiled. Now I am seeing, in every Kannada department or in Telugu department or Tamil department in any university, it's becoming the department of anthropology or sociology. I always say, those departments are there. Why you need yours? Why can't it be merged? The identity of literature should be maintained. It measured through these yardsticks of that thing, this thing and all that. Whether any disease which is reflected in the West, that chronic disease in one of its partial dimensions has to be reflected here also. The same thing. So that's why the very purpose of art is to transcend all purposes. But do social revolution through literature, it's all nonsense.
No, not, but the problem is, you see, this is where, this is your view. If you look at it from the point of social sciences, these people who are doing literature are doing bad social science.
Yes, they are novices.
So they are bad literature, yeah. They
are also, books, They are not referring to the first-hand books, authoritative books, and they are not deep, well-versed. There they are catching hold of the pamphlets.
Exactly.
At that level of propagandism,
exactly.
Some chauvinism, they are doing
exactly.
Here I find the problem. That's how I went to RSS people and said, when our arts are spoiled like that, why can't you revive our arts? Not as art for art's sake, enjoy it and forget it. Pure dance or pure music, something like that. But they are not.
They are not interested. Why?
Because nationalism of that dimension sometimes, it becomes another enigma of this sort.
Absolutely. Why is it they are not interested?
Because regimentation, however good it may be, it spoils sensitivity. And the problem with sensitivity is it can't mobilize a movement. In our tradition, I think, people were at the individualistic level, they used to work. And the sincerity, commitment and sensitivity, that only used to pulsate the rest, transmit the things. That's how it used to happen, I think. And interdisciplinary approach, a person knowing so many things firsthand, was our way. Ekam shastra madhiyano nagache shastra niranayam. One who has been well-versed in only one subject cannot make a conclusive, decisive statement even in that subject. A Bhaskaracharya, a mathematician of 11th century, how was he? He is student raised. Ashtav Vyakaranani, new 8 systems of grammar. Bhishajam Vyachashta, Sapta Bhishajam Vyachashta Tasamita, 7 systems of medicines. And then Shattarkan, 6 philosophies, you know. Ganitani Pancha Bhubude, 5 systems of astrology. Astronomy, Saur Siddhanta, Romak Siddhanta, Druk Siddhanta and all that. And then Chaturo Vedhan. And then Ratnanam Tridyam, Gemology, Mineralogy and Metallurgy. Mimamsa Yorantaram, Karma Brahma, Yekam Brahma, Agada Bodha Mahima, Sosyah Kavi Bhaskaraha. This integrated approach, they don't want it. Padma Subramanyam often says to me, I see music and I listen to dance. This is needed. They are not encouraging that. Now slowly they are doing in the name of Sanskara Bharati and all. There also, the theme is nationalism. No, it should come out as a suggestion. It should not become explicit. I don't find any great poetry in Janaganamana or Vande Mataram. If I say, they beat me. I don't care. ಇಕ್ರಲ್ ರಾ ಬದಲ್ರಲ್ರ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಿದ್ಧಲಿಂಗ ಏನೋ ಕವಿತೆ ಹೇಗೋ ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಏನು ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಪೊಯಿಟ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಪೊಯಿಟ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ಸಜೆಷನ್, ಹಾಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಕೋಪ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಾರೆ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೆನಿಗ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪೊಯಿಟಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್. ಎ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಈವೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಎಂಬ್ರೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಎ ಫೆನಾಮಿನನ್ ಬೈ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒಂದೇ ಮಾತ್ರ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹೊಲಿಮಾದೇವರ ಹಾಡು ಆಫ್ ಸಿದ್ಧಲಿಂಗ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. But they never went ahead of time by their own merit. Like that, one should have a dispassionate approach to the things prevalent. There, I think, intellectualism now is shunning celebration. That's one more thing. Seriousness should not be lack of joy. I have not seen any so-called intellect in a mirthful, happy mood. No comfortable positions I see there.